Hi there. Thanks for coming by PosterCentral.com's video blog today. I'm Pete Howard, and I've got a really nice, cool Seminole Bill Graham concert poster here from the other coast, from the East Coast. And it's in a plastic protective art holder, acid-free backing and everything. It's loose, but it's in the holder. So we're going to get some reflection from the sun outside my window. But I felt that natural light was really nice for lighting the poster. And so we'll just put up with the occasional glare and stuff, and I'll hold it at an angle. But anyway, what we have here is simply the first concert poster from Bill Graham's Fillmore East in New York City, in Greenwich Village, of course. And obviously his West Coast Fillmore and eventually Fillmore West posters and everything were, you know, set the entire stage for concert poster collecting pretty much in the world. But here's his first Fillmore East one. So we're talking March of 1968 here, and we're talking Janis Joplin with Big Brother and the Holding Company on the cusp of superstardom. This poster for me, it's interesting. It's a black and white poster, but it really works for me. I mean, you know, the psychedelic colors were one of the hallmarks of Graham's West Coast concert posters, along with the Family Dogs from Chet Helms. But this one, I really like the, it's not a simple design, but it's a black and white design, and I think it just works really nicely. It was designed by a guy named Charles Brandywine. And what's nice is that, well, first of all, I'll give you a quick close-in look. You've seen the image probably. They made a handbill that looks just like this. But there you've got the opening acts underneath Big Brother, right under Janis, in fact, Tim Buckley and Albert King. And there's the band name over on this side of the poster. Again, it won't be a new image to that many of you, but it's just, this is the full-size poster, and it does have condition issues. It's got a couple of big tears and so forth, but, you know, originality and first printings are what us collectors covet, so I was happy to get this in any condition. Oops, as I bump things around and stuff. So, anyway, as I said, Charles Brandywine designed the poster, but it features prominently a photo by, see that name credit right under Janis's face? Linda Eastman. And of course, 99% of you know that Linda Eastman went on to marry Paul McCartney and become Linda McCartney. But she was part of the New York photographic music scene very much when Paul met her. And so here she's got a real nice placement on this poster. Now, interestingly, it does say the Fillmore East, and of course they have to specify that that's formerly, or ex-Village Theater. It's interesting, Graham, you know, took over the East Coast concert series. He took over the theater, I'm trying to say, the Village Theater, and he was going to call it just the Village Theater, Bill Graham's Village Theater, something like that. And at the last minute, but in enough time to print these posters, he christened it the Fillmore East, which I think just about everybody agrees historically was a really good choice and a really good name for it. Interestingly, he installed like a new state-of-the-art sound system in the theater, and everybody really spiffied up the theater. They wanted to make a really great impression. Bill Graham's autobiography, which was co-written, is a really good source for you know, finding out some of the atmosphere and information about this historic first concert on the East Coast for Bill. But had like a $35,000 new sound system. And notice it says on here, which is so prominent on a lot of posters, Joshua Light Show. That's Joshua White. And he really pitched in renovating the Village Theater, painting the, you know, new coat of paint on the box office lobby and everything, so he was really involved. And 2,300 people attended per show, and it's really interesting to see that it's 8 p.m. and 11 p.m. shows. See that? In fact, I love the way it says PERFs, abbreviation for performances. But, boy, is that a throwback to the 60s, an 11:15 show? In fact, that show didn't let out till 2:30 in the morning. How often does that happen anymore? I mean, we all go to, you know, still go to our occasional concerts, and seems like by 10:30 or something, you know, we're headed for home and to bed and stuff. But boy, getting out at 2:30 and starting at 11:15, that was one of the hallmarks of 60s rock concerts for sure. Now, I mentioned the two opening acts pictured below Big Brother there, Tim Buckley, of course, a singer-songwriter who had released two albums by this point, and only one had charted. And Buckley, unfortunately, of course, would go on to an early demise from drugs at the age of 28. And his son, of course, is Jeff Buckley, was Jeff Buckley, another musician. And interestingly, below that, though, Albert King, 45-year-old Albert King, who had, he had actually been recording for 15 years but had not placed an album on Billboard's album charts yet because he was a niche blues man, right? But Graham really liked him. Bill Graham, in fact, in his bio, just sung praises about Albert King. What a good guy he was to work with, reliable, showed up, worked hard, really nice man, and really had a rapport with the audience, with Graham's audiences on the West Coast. So we brought him out for his first East show, and Albert King is sort of a mainstay on a lot of Bill Graham posters. Interestingly, in fact, as I said, he'd been recording for 15 years and charted nothing because he was a niche blues man. But the year before, in 1967, his album Born Under a Bad Sign came out. And that really started to cross him over to white audiences, and the white musicians really started noticing him. And then later this year, in 1968, Albert King finally charted his first of something like 8 albums that would sort of cross over and hit the Billboard chart. And interestingly, that record later in 68, which was very influential on a lot of guitarists like Clapton and even Hendrix and stuff, it was recorded at Bill Graham's Fillmore West. So that's pretty neat. So anyway, it's really a nice, it's sometimes nicknamed FE1 for Fillmore East 1, because there'd be a few other Bill Graham concert posters from the Fillmore East. Famously, things like The Who and Hendrix, very recognizable designs. But this is FE1. It's a really fun poster from March of 1968. Big Brother and the Holding Company, of course, right around this time, was recording the studio tracks on Cheap Thrills, and probably the live tracks on Cheap Thrills were recorded around this time as well. And then comes the summer, Cheap Thrills would come out, and Peace of My Heart, and they would become absolute superstars, or Janis certainly would, obviously, and go solo the next year. But here you have a nice positioning of Big Brother before their first mainstream album on mainstream records, and their Columbia debut with Cheap Thrills, and it's just really a nice time in their career. And I think the photograph, it's not because Linda McCartney took it, I think it's a really strong rendition of all five Big Brother members. They just look really good, and Janis right in the middle with a big smile. I think that photo, or actually it's obviously composite five headshots, gives this poster with this black and white design most of its strength. So, really nice piece. Great Janis piece for sure, and obviously a really important East Coast New York City concert poster. So, hope you enjoyed it. Thanks a lot for stopping by, and we'll see you next time. Have a good day. Bye-bye.